as far as being an actor and going to the next level, something like Netflix, the whole Netflix situation.
Baby, you know? I appreciate how you brought that back around. He was going to get it in, okay?
People need to understand, and with technology evolving and these different platforms, of course, with these high streaming numbers, so that means there's high revenue in mm-hmm. those arenas and things like that. Is from your perspective, just clear the air on this. Is there a disconnect when it comes to certain actors and actresses, even in this platform, as far as Netflix is concerned?
Well, when you say clear the air on this as if it is something new, when has there ever been equality for a black woman? So when you say clear the air, like, is this, when you know that Hollywood, corporate America, right. this radio station, when has it ever been equality for a black woman? So there's nothing for me to clear the air about. We all know that that's what it is. I think that what's happening now, people are saying, we don't believe you said it out loud. We don't believe you called it to the table. Because oftentimes, we know that it's happening, but we're so fearful, we won't say anything. We get so fearful that we'll ask questions like, well, is it really like that? When we know what it is. You already know as a black man about inequality. So you have people that then become journalists and just start asking questions, but not having a conversation. I can ask my sister right here. Have you ever had a run-in with inequality?
Absolutely.
Right. So if we start having...
Don't look at me.
Oh, okay.
Uh-oh. Okay. I'm just a nerd.
Yeah, she turned and looked at me.
When we begin to have the real open and honest dialogue is when it gets better. But as long as we keep having these conversations with a question mark, well, it doesn't get better because we already know the answer. So with Netflix, with Hollywood, it's always been inequality, always. And the feeling was, just be happy we welcomed you to the table. Well, if I come to the table, I'm not just going to eat the crumbs. You got to give me what you're giving everybody else. And as a matter of fact, don't have to eat at your table. We can go to our own table. That's why we're bringing the neighborhood barbershop to our communities. Because what this is saying is, we're not waiting on nobody.
Yeah.
We're going to bring it ourselves. So when Melvin Childs calls and says, listen, I want to put a play up. What do y'all think? And it makes sense. Yes, we're going to do it because it's our craft. It's our art. And oftentimes people think, oh, if you're not in Hollywood, you ain't doing it.
Yeah.
We bought into foolishness. We're entertainers. And we entertain where, Alan?
On the stage.
Come on. All over the world, baby. If they had, if Melvin called and said, listen, I talked to some people on Venus.
Right.
Right. Now, the money is green, but the people going to look a little funny. What y'all say? We on our way, Melvin. Okay? Now, if she got three eyes looking on me, baby, it might be a problem. But we're going
to
do it.
So what would you say to that next actor or actress that's coming up and that they're going to encounter those same things and not to settle for those crumbs? What would you say to them to inspire them to get ready for it?
I would say boycott Netflix. Right now. Boycott they ass, baby. And what I would say is don't waver. Don't waver. Because what happens is, there were people that said to me, Monique, why didn't you just do what Wanda Sykes did? And Wanda Sykes is my baby. She just went somewhere else. And I tell them because her name is Wanda Sykes. And my name is Monique. And if we keep going somewhere else and we don't speak on it, it never changes. They say, okay, well, they went somewhere else. We'll get the next one. So what I say is know your worth. And be unapologetic about it. And when people say, oh, they're not going to pay you that, then I'm not going to play with them. Mm-hmm. It's just that simple. So for the babies coming in, yeah, you got dues to pay.
Yeah.
We're still paying dues. I don't have no problem with that. Right. But when you pay that dude, then that comes with that money. Yeah. When you pay that dude, that comes with that money. And be unwavering about your craft, your talent, and know your money.
That's great input.
Javia, Jessica, and Jada, they can tell you what the numbers are. She put it out there like, this is what it is. You know, and that's just Mo. But you need to understand.
Oh, that's Liv Liv.
And let me say, Terry and I, we actually played that on the air of your Instagram video you did in front of your trophy, everything, all of your awards and accolades with your husband.
Wasn't that beautiful? Oh, baby, me and my daddy stood right there. Go ahead, baby.
And the way you talked about the inequality of the money that had been coming in compared to her. I know, call me just naive for this because I probably hadn't been following it as much, but has Amy Schumer commented at all?
Not that I'm aware of. you know, Amy Schumer has a comment, and another comment I want to make.
Get a little bit
closer. Oh, I'm sorry, not that I'm aware of, because you brought up my husband, who was also my manager. And there are people that say, oh, Monique, you need to get rid of him. He don't know what he's doing. He's going to mess up your career. And people aren't reading in between the lines. Jessica Chastain had to go fight for Octavia Spencer and Jada Pinkett Smith. Where were their agents and managers to fight for them? See, what people are upset with my husband about is he won't accept the lowball offers, because he'll say to them, you have to make that make sense. And when they can't make it make sense, oh, Monique's husband difficult. He won't take these slave wages. He will not let us treat them like they. So I say to our people, wake up. Wake up. Octavia is an Academy Award winner. She has double the credits that Sister Jessica has on her resume. So why isn't it that Octavia's representatives, see, her representatives were supposed to say, no, 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 no. We can't accept that. Jada's representatives were supposed to say, we can't accept that. Why did it take this woman? And we say to Sister Jessica, hey, baby, we thank you. But where were their teams? Where were their representatives? Because, see, I've had the big time Hollywood agents and the big time Hollywood manager and the big time Hollywood attorney. And you know what they told me? Monique, we'll get them on the next one. Why the hell I gotta keep waiting to the next one? Now I'm 25 years in, and you still wanna tell me we're gonna get them on the next one? No, baby, we gotta get them on this one. And if not, we're gonna go ahead and pass, because it doesn't make sense. But we get so caught up in, oh, y'all doing it wrong. You're not bowing down. Well, that's why Octavia Spencer keeps getting those offers. And Jada and all of the other sisters in Hollywood, because where's our representation? Saying, we can't allow that. And Octavia is dynamic. Jada dynamic. When you see a movie like Girls Trip, they made over $100 million, but not one of them was paid $1 million. And when you see Gary Owens fighting so hard for Will Packer, with all he's done for the black community, well, when you pull up Will Packer, he's known for doing low-budget movies, making high profits. Who gets the high profits? Damn sure not us. See, when we did Almost Christmas, Danny Glover, Gabrielle Union, Kimberly Elise, Monique, J.B. Smoove, an amazing cast. Nobody in that cast was paid over $1 million, all of us included. All of us included. So when you know that and you see that, you've got to speak on it. You've got to speak on it. I've got to speak on it. Because if not, I could not go to sleep comfortably at night.
Let me ask you about the Precious movie.
Yes.
What did you do to prepare for that? I think it seemed like that could have been a very emotional project. Was that for you?
I'm going to say this with all humility that I can say it with.
Yeah.
I didn't do anything to prepare for that. I knew that character. And that character was my brother Gerald.
Yeah.
So the moment when Mr. Daniels said action, I knew that person. So, and it wasn't this deep, dark place. It was, we were acting. So when he said cut, we went and started playing and had a good time. So it wasn't this heavy thing. It was called acting.
Yeah.
So, you know, people say, well, did you have to go to class? And the best advice I got was from my husband.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, Mama, don't judge her. Just be her.
That's great. I remember when you were, of course, filling in and doing the Michael Bazin show, and I thought you were going to stay with it. For some reason, I was like, oh, Monique's got it. She's going to take this and run with it. Are you still doing radio back on the East Coast? Are you planning on ever getting back to radio?
I absolutely had an amazing time. We actually did a radio show, the Monique Show.
Yeah.
On radio. I had an amazing time. And if it makes sense, it's just got to make sense.
Right.
If that's all. It's just got to make sense if it makes sense.
Can you see yourself doing that and maybe syndication and picking up stations, maybe a morning show or something like that?
If it makes sense.
Okay.
Just got to make sense, baby. That's all it is.
Yeah.
Just business. Gotta make sense.
But there are other variables.
Exactly.
Talk to
like
them.
Family, location.
Right.
You know, all of these things. So it isn't just business.
See, Alan, you bring the part to it that most are afraid to say out loud. Because oftentimes in Hollywood, it's about the fluff. They don't want to talk about family. They don't want to talk about location. It's just, they're going to pay you that money? Girl, you better go to hell and get it. Because that's all it is.
Right.
But they don't talk about, well, how does this affect your family?
Yeah, right.
How does this affect 10 years from now? It's all about, we got to get that bag right now and forget everything else. And we don't realize what the priorities are. So oftentimes when you get in this business, talk to a lot of the moguls in this business.
Yeah.
And then ask them about their families.
Yeah.
Okay. Very few of them have any.
Yeah.
Because they focus so much on getting a bag that they didn't know how to be a wife or a husband or a mommy.
Yeah.
Ask a mogul, how do you bake a cake from scratch? Then ask a mogul when they get in their 80s. Do you wish you would have had a family? Because now all the lights and cameras are gone.
Yeah.
Now there's no more fanfare. Now it's you and your dogs. Don't you wish you would have had a family? So it's just understanding the priorities. It's not always just business. Like Alan said, there are other layers that go to it that make you make those decisions.
Yeah. Wow. Both of you are sharing, dropping some jewels, some serious knowledge, of course, for us as well as our listeners.
That's what this play is about, sugar. Yeah. And we're going back to it. That's what the Neighborhood Barbershop is about, because in it, things are being dropped that oftentimes we don't get dropped to us.
Yes.
Because like Alan was saying, this is a generation of iPads and TV, not parenting. So we're missing those little drop-ins. We're missing those little jewels. And in this play, baby, they are drop-ins. Yeah. And they are jewels happening all throughout the play that we're missing.
Yeah. I can honestly say, based off of our conversation and the jewels that both of you have been dropping, both of you, I can see now you are a master at your craft. So, yeah, most definitely. I just much love and respect to both, to each and every one of you.
Being formulated. I'm being taken different places and in different places in my life, in my memory, but also I'm being taken places in the future because I'm looking at the difference between black folks who remember when black folks had a community and now they're black folks, young millennial black folks are so integrated into mainstream society, they don't even remember that we ever had a community because they see themselves as a part of the larger society. So, and those messages are being dropped as well.
Deep.
Well, I want to, if you don't mind, I do want to go back to, if you don't mind, Miss Monique, to Precious.
Yes.
And just your thoughts in winning, stepping on that stage, getting that Oscar. What were your thoughts?
You know, the Oscar wasn't the be-all, the end-all for me. And everybody, especially that looks like me, asked me about the Oscar. But no one ever asked me about the Image Award. No one ever said to me, how did you feel when you walked on stage and got the Image Award? And that's what happens to us. We put value on what a white community says is the best, but we don't put any value on ours. So I'll tell you what it felt like to get that Image Award the night they called my name. I remember coming up watching the Image Awards, and all those people look like me. And I never watched the Oscars because none of those people look like me. So I didn't grow up saying, oh, I can't wait for that call my name for an Oscar. That was never something that was on my list.
Yeah.
But that Image Award, when I saw those black women walk up on that stage, I was like, wow, one day they're going to call my name. And the day they called my name, when I tell you, Alan, I don't know if I walked. If you watch the tape back, I may have flew and jumped over a couple of the seats because I was that little girl that was watching the Image Award. And they said, and the winner is Monique. So that was the award for me that made my heart say, dreams do come true. Now, the night I did get that Oscar, I was appreciative, as I'm appreciative of every award I've ever received. But that night wasn't the woo night for me. It was an Image Award night. So the woo night for me at the Oscar was not walking up on the stage. It was when Robin Williams and I were walking to our seats. And that man looked at me and said, hey, you know I'm giving you that award tonight. And he said, oh, no, I'm just calling your category. And we hugged as two comedians. We hugged as two regular old comedians that know what it's like to get in your car and drive around this country making $50 and $75 a night. To now you're gonna bring me up on stage to give me an award. That was the moment for me. That wasn't the moment. for me, but I understand why we think it is, because we've been told to believe that's the moment.
And you know, I want to address that specifically because I'm talking to my people. And with Monique's circumstances regarding Netflix and all of that, I just want to say this to you and to my people, that this concept, there's an illusion that we have. This whole civilization is an illusion. All of it. It's not what you think it is, but you're designed to believe it's something. And as black folks, you can't be invested in something that's not elevating you. You can't be aspiring to get something from somebody that has no value in you. It doesn't matter whether they value or not. It doesn't matter whether they give you $500 million. It doesn't matter if they give you $1 billion. That's not what matters. What matters is, do they value you? And if they don't value you, then you need to recognize that and value yourself and build your own. This need to receive accolades, money, you can do business, you know, we got the internet, you can do your own business by yourself. You got your own community. That's why I say these folks looking at stuff and trying to merge who they are, how they monetize themselves on Instagram and all of this based on larger society. All of that's engineered.
Come on.
All of that's designed for you to take yourself away from yourself. So you got to wake up, understand what the intent is behind all of this, because this is not accidental. So I just wanted to just make a statement about that.
I was going to say, and no disrespect for even asking that, but the reason that I did ask is because, you know, when we saw Oprah Winfrey get on that stage and she received her award and an achievement, and she talked about that moment when she saw Sidney Poitier receive an award, and he looked like her. You know, there are young girls, even myself, watching you on that stage to receive that Oscar. It resonates when you see people, you're in a sea of people that don't look like you, but you were chosen as the person to be honored for your craft and your gift and what you brought to the screen. And that's why I speak to those young women who saw you on that stage in 2010 and said, wow, you know, I've seen her. I've seen her on comedy shows. I've seen her in this movie. I've seen her in other movies, but she was praised on that evening, and I can do that too.
You know, when I speak to our young sisters, you can do that. But it's not about that stage. Because when you come off the stage, the money doesn't change. Actually, the money gets lower. So for me to speak to my young sisters, talk about that night on the stage, that's unfair. Because all they want to do is get to that night on the stage. But not understanding that our sister Octavia Spencer, who's won an Oscar, had to have our white sister Jessica Chastain fight for her, who's not won an Oscar. She's been nominated, but she's not won it. She had to fight for her to get fair pay. So for me to tell my sisters about that night, well, I know what happens after that night. So I got to talk to them about after that night. I got to talk to them about it ain't even about that night. If they never gave me an award, but you gave me fair pay, keep your awards, baby. The award is I was given the gift. And the universe allows me to use the gift. That's the award. That's the reward. Not you giving me a trophy. That Oscar is worth $1. In the contract you sign, you cannot give it away. You cannot sell it. If you want to sell it, you have to give it back to the Academy, and it's worth $1. So what would you like for me to say to my little sisters about walking up on that stage? I've walked up on it, and I've been behind the scenes. And what I know is, walking up on that stage, baby, it doesn't mean the same for black women that it means for our white sisters or our white men. It just doesn't mean the same. So when I walked up on that Image Award stage, I was doing the Parkers. And every time I walked up on that stage, my check got different. I was able to go back and say, my community said that they really like me. So you need to put that in my money. Because that's my community saying that. But when I won that award, as you know, now all the trouble started. Monique's difficult and she's demanding. Well, all I'm asking for is what y'all said I was supposed to get when you win this award. Y'all keep coming with these
$25 offers? Where's the $25 million offers? Where's the $5 million offers? Where are those offers? So we've got to understand, we put value on things that really shouldn't be valuable, in my humble opinion.
Yeah. Appreciate that.